Mr. Solanke, President of SME Chamber of India, Mr. Malaya, the Chief Guest and CMD of Bank of Baroda, Mr. Srinath, Mr. Dogra, Mr. Srinivasan, Mr. Jay Gupta, Mr. Pandey, and my dear delegates and friends. It is indeed a privilege and a pleasure to be associated with the SME Chamber of India and to be able to participate in such interesting conferences. I must compliment Mr. Chandrakant Solanke for setting up this forum for entrepreneurs, lenders, and other stakeholders to come together in a very large numbers and to be able to interact freely on topics of importance to the SME world. Now we come to the point, why are we having this summit, which is an annual summit on finance and investment for SMEs? We all know that SMEs are of great socio-economic significance, although they have been, their growth, their competitiveness have been constrained frequently by very chronic problems and by very acute constraints. And this is something which has not disappeared over the decades that we have been talking about SME problems and issues. And this needs to be continuously highlighted and more and better solutions found for these constraints. SME's share of financing resources is really disproportionately less compared to their significance. Mr. Venkatachalam was talking about the share of SMEs in the economy in terms of 40% in production, 45% in employment, and very significant share of the GDP proportion. But in terms of the institutional lending to the corporate and manufacturing and services sector, are SMEs getting a proportionate share? Definitely no. The statistics reveal that they are getting less than half their share of their contribution in terms of value addition to the economy. That means there is a bottleneck somewhere. There is a failure, a systemic failure somewhere, whereby a proportionate measure of resources is not being channeled to this very, very important sector. Now, SME financing problems arise both from the demand side and the supply side. From the demand side, from the SME side, the lenders constantly harp on the need for more systematic disclosure of information on the finance, on their governance practices, on better business planning by SMEs. These are well taken, and SMEs need to address these concerns, and practitioners, experts in this summit would tell you how you can go about better handling these problems and issues so that the lenders are more receptive to SMEs when they approach them for finance. On the supply side, easier access to both debt financing, mainly from the banking system, and risk capital from both the venture capital funds, PE funds, and other informal sources. I think this is something that has been a crying need for SMEs. And further, as our president very rightly mentioned, greater reliance on credit information systems, credit reports, etc., while it is starting to happen, there is inconsistency in the way these are accessed and actually implemented. We need to have more consistent SME risk scoring across the lending spectrum, so that for the same SME with the same financial, same balance sheet, we get very, very widely differing perceptions among the lenders, widely differing reactions among the lenders. I think this is something which is very uncomfortable to the SMEs when they approach the lenders. When they have a standardized system of credit scoring, then they would know where they stand and they would know what reception they would get from various lenders, irrespective of which bank they are going to. I think this becomes very important. There is also a very great paradigm shift now happening in the global world. The Indian economy has got truly globalized, and SMEs, which form 40% of the economy in very many respects, I think they are also feeling the full impact of globalization. If that is happening, it is also bringing in huge amount of global competition. We know that many countries, particularly our great neighbor China, has become much more competitive in manufacturing than any other country, and their manufacturing competitiveness is not only affecting the large corporates in India, but it is very much affecting the small and medium enterprises. If this competition has to be overcome, if this large trade surplus of which is on track for $20 billion is with China, if the Chinese trade surplus of $20 billion is to be overcome, the SMEs have to put their shoulder to the wheel. They have to contribute significantly in terms of competitiveness of their products to be able to meet this competition head on. So these are all issues which have to be discussed, debated, ideas picked up from various investors and applied on the ground by SMEs. What is the scenario of constraints that we are talking about? There are persistent constraints on SME financing, particularly very restrictive terms and conditions in approval of loans. Again, Mr. Salunkhe mentioned about this. Yes, we have been doing SME financing for five decades now, but we are still finding that the perception of lenders, banks towards SMEs is still frequently not what the sector would desire. It is the risk perception that they have about SMEs seems to overpower a lot of other considerations and seem to become the lens through which the SMEs get looked at with a lot of anxiety, if not suspicion. I think this is something which has to be modified very significantly. If you look world over in the most successful economies, let us take here United States of America, which is one of the most entrepreneurially successful economies in the world. In USA, the average number of failures before an enterprise succeeds is 3. There are enterprises which fail on an average 3 times before they are able to come up with very successful small, medium or large enterprises. Is there a scope in India for 3 times failure before you succeed? I am afraid that is not the scenario. That is no. I think the entire financial world needs to look at this and understand that genuine failures are not treated as a stigma for future enterprise attempts by the entrepreneurs. I think this is a very, very basic problem or bottleneck in the Indian financing system, which comes in the way of the entrepreneurial skills which are developed through failures becoming the anchor for future successes. Again, if we have to engender widespread entrepreneurial spirit among the Indian population, we need to make everyone an entrepreneur, whether they are working in separate private their own enterprises or they are even working in a salaried paid employment anywhere. They have to think and work like entrepreneurs. Again, taking the example of USA, before the age of 60, every single American worker has at least once in his working career been an entrepreneur. This again is something which really generates entrepreneurship and innovation. I think we need to develop a culture where this kind of things are encouraged. We also have constraints relating to the perverse incentive syndrome. In the well-meaning attempt by the government to attract larger capital investment, to encourage bigger capital investment, which generates definitely growth of infrastructure, growth of wealth in the hinterland, the incentives tend to be loaded in favor of the larger enterprises. I think this is again something which needs to be relooked and seen how these perverse incentives syndrome could be reversed as far as SMEs are concerned. There is a complex legal and regulatory environment which makes the decision making somewhat opaque. It is definitely a complement to the Central Banking Authority of India, the Reserve Bank of India, that it has brought in tremendous amount of transparency in the last decade into its policy making decisions, and this is something which needs to go further down the road before SMEs can see the full transparency of policy making in their own fields of endeavor. On balance, the direct indirect intervention by the by the government, by the regulators, very well meaning no doubt, has not been able to compensate fully for the various natural biases against the SME sector, which have been unintentionally introduced maybe, or which is inherent within because of the risk perception relating to SMEs in the domestic policy and financing network. These are the specific areas which have to be looked at with a microscope and addressed by the regulators, by the CEOs of financial institutions and banks, to be able to remove these bottlenecks in the field of, in the way of the SME entrepreneurs. In this summit, we hope that there would be a wide-ranging knowledge coverage, because any growth and development of the SME sector is going to not only contribute in a greater measure to the economy, but it is going to help empower the private sector as a whole in its global integration efforts. The sessions cover success factors for growth of SMEs, better financial and risk management, ways to get adequate funding, need for credit rating, commercial finance opportunities, private equity and venture capital funding, opportunities arising from the proposed SME exchange, the restructuring of stressed assets, which again I think is a very, very important area because of the factors I mentioned, that entrepreneurship really develops and stabilizes only when failures are seen as part of the system, as long as they are genuine failures without malafide intentions. Again, need for a changed mindset is something that will continue to be addressed both on the part of the entrepreneurs in their approach and in their complaints about the government and the lenders, but also on the part of the lenders in their approach towards the SMEs. A lot of concrete approaches and practical methodologies are expected to be presented in this summit, and we hope that these would all play a part, because there are constraints relating to lack of sufficient collateral among SMEs, lack of a strong balance sheet, squeezed credit periods by the suppliers, brunt of high costs because of the higher risk perception by the lenders, the low capital which prevents them from going and raising public equity. All these issues will have to be tackled in some form or other, and I'm sure we'll pick up a lot of ideas during this summit. In private equity partnership, which is an engine for growth of SMEs enterprise across the world, if you look at the Indian scenario, it has been pretty weak. While SMEs would improve in terms of their corporate governance, management structure and long-term vision with the association of private and private equity and venture capital funds, these are very few and far between now. In a normal year, 5 to 7 investors doing 30 odd deals is the enterprise scenario, the venture funding or private equity scenario in India. This is totally inadequate and nowhere near our requirements. I think the experts on the various panels will tell you how to attract more such funding and how to make use of the partnerships with such funds. There are challenges relating to developing capabilities of SMEs, how to get investors attracted by guaranteeing much better valuations than the large enterprises are able to provide, how to negotiate with venture capital and funds and lenders by using and leveraging your strengths and projecting your strengths, how you will source funds for seed capital. All these will be discussed in the session. Our visionary president, Mr. Salunke, mentioned in his opening address about the shortage of skilled manpower for SMEs. I think this is something that I would like to just touch upon before I close the theme, though it is not on the formal agenda of our seminar. I had recently attended a UNICEF-sponsored seminar on role of corporates in universalizing education. I think the role of SMEs in universalizing education, I think, is something which has been left out both as a blind spot by the policymakers and by the SMEs themselves. I think there is a very great measure of stake involved for SMEs in ensuring that good quality universal education, good quality technical education from ITIs, polytechnics come up, so that the right kind of workforce comes to the SMEs. The cream of the students are not going to join the SMEs. They are going to, from IITs and IIMs, they are going to go to the top corporates, big corporates. It is the next level, the middle level of students from these enterprises, from the school, high schools, from the technical institutes are going to come to you. So it is important for you all to participate in ensuring that this improves. You can set up SME camps, maybe 1 week camps in nearby areas, train high school students, expose them to SME manufacturing practices.